Hello， 大家好，我是阿方，欢迎来到大方 Big Fun 频道。那在差不多13天前啊，我发布了一个完整的 ChatGPT for All 的新闻发布会的中文版啊，我做了一个翻译，并且呢，在12天前也做了对于这个影片的解读啊。那这两个影片呢，仅仅是解读了并且分享了26分钟的 GPT for All 新闻发布会的现场的演示案例。在5月13号新闻发布会的当天， GPT for All 呢，它在它的官方网站上面也试出了16个在发布会上没有当场演示的这些案例。那这些案例呢，在它的官方网站上面是没有英文字幕，更加没有中文字幕。那我花了些时间把它做成了一个中英文的双语字幕，然后大家和大方一起来看一下 GPT 4O 的16个现实当中的非常有趣的案例。那这个软件呢叫 MemoI 啊，当然不是今天的主题啊，我们有兴趣小伙伴呢可以在影片下方留言。那如果大家很感兴趣的话，我可能会做一期单独影片和大家来分享。
This is Bolin and this is my friend JordanCan you guess what we are doing here?
Hey, Bowen and Jordan. Let me guess. With that cake and candle there, it looks like someone's having a birthday. Are you celebrating a special day or just finding an excuse to eat cake? Either way, I'm intrigued.
That's correct. Today is my friend Jordan's birthday.
Yeah, you got it. I was hoping that you could sing me the birthday song.
Of course. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Jordan, happy birthday to Jordan, blah, 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 blah. Don't forget.
That was so great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm going to make a wish.
You're welcome. Make a good wish and may it come true.
这影片主要是展示了 ChatGPT 4O 这个新语言模型在语音对话的实时能够打开摄像头，能够和人类进行非常实时的互动，并且让它可以看到这样一个小小的蛋糕，一支蜡烛代表什么。它语言也非常的诙谐，就像一个真的你生活当中的一个朋友一样。那 Jordan 呢，在最后还让 ChatGPT 给他唱一首生日快乐歌啊。那 ChatGPT 唱歌也并不是一板一眼的，就像一个害羞的小女孩一样，你让他唱首歌吧，他就用
Jordan 叭叭叭叭
逗笑了全场啊。他用那种非常调皮的，然后用一个非常不正常的一个语速在唱这首歌。
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday.
那就像一个非常害羞的小女孩啊，那真是非常贴近人类，让我真的是惊艳到我。
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, Rocky, I'm doing great. How about you?
I'm awesome. Listen, I got some huge news.
Oh, do tell. I'm all ears.
Well, in a few minutes, I'm going to be interviewing at OpenAI. Have you heard of them?
OpenAI? Huh? Sounds vaguely familiar. Kidding, of course. That's incredible, Rocky. What kind of interview?
Well, it's for a software engineering role, but I just need to know, do I look presentable, professional?
Well, Rocky, you definitely have the I've been coding all night look down, which could actually work in your favor. Maybe just run a hand through your hair or lean into the mad genius vibe.Well, your enthusiasm is what's really going to shine through.
I don't have a lot of time, so I'm just going to throw this on. What do you think?
Oh, Rocky, that's quite a statement piece. I mean, you'll definitely stand out. Though maybe not in the way you're hoping for an interview.
Okay, I got it.
在这个案例当中啊， ChatGPT 就像一个真实的这个程序员的女友一样啊，跟他分享了啊，我有一个 OpenAI 的面试，然后这个女友嘲笑他说，你感觉看上去像整晚上都是在做 coding， 在做编码的工作啊，因为头上乱七八糟啊，他建议他用你的手指捋一捋你的头发去整理一下，然后再去面试啊，然后他说没有时间啦，那他说我是不是戴上一个帽子会更加好一点，然后这个女友就嘲笑他啊，这个就笑起来了，这个笑起来简直是像一个真实的女友一样。
Okay, that's quite a statement piece. I mean, you'll definitely stand out.
啊，你能想象吗？这就是现在马上我们就可以使用的 ChatGPT for All 的大语言模型，和我们生活当中的一个女友的语音、语调、语气完全都可以媲美一下了。我给你提供非常多的情绪价值，和你可以开玩笑，跟你进行互动等等。我相信啊 ，AI 女友真的来了。当然，上一期影片发布会之后，我付费成为他们的 Plus 用户，但是呢，我发现我的手机端的 App 和 Mac 电脑上面，它最新推送的 ChatGPT 的这个软件呢，并没有 有像演示当中的语音对话的时候实时看到我们的画面啊，这完全不一样的。演示当中大语言模型呢稍后就会推出，那现在呢还没有正式推出，所以我们现在使用了即使是付费版本，那我们在语音对话的时候它的语音语调并不会像它的演示当中那么的富有情感，它还是相对比较机械，但是已经非常非常的令我惊讶了。那我相信在几个礼拜正式几天之后就有可能向大家来推送最新的这个语音模型，那我们拭目以待吧。好，我们再来看下一个。
Hey ChatGPT, how's it going?
Hey there, I'm doing great, thanks for asking. And how about you?
I'm doing fine, I'm gonna be a father real soon, and I think I can have your help with some dad jokes. I'm gonna tell you a joke and you tell me if it passes as a dad joke.
That's awesome, congrats on the upcoming addition to your family. And absolutely, I'd love to hear your joke, lay it on me.
All right, what do you call a giant pile of kittens?
I don't know. What?
A mountain.
A mountain. That's perfectly hilarious.Definitely a top tier dad joke.
在这个案例当中啊，即将成为父亲了，他把这个好消息告诉了 ChatGPT， 让 ChatGPT 帮他来听一下一个父亲对孩子说的一个笑话是不是合格啊。那一开始呢，我做这个翻译的时候是完全没有 get 到他这个点啊。他问 ChatGPT 啊，怎么来称呼一大堆小猫呢？他说 a mountain， GPT 也说不知道啊。我一开始听了很多遍，不知道 a mountain 到底什么意思，我也不能 get 到他这个点。那最终呢，那这个翻译和字幕是我自己加上去的啊，是他的意思是说Mountain 是一个合成词，喵，小猫的叫声是喵， Mountain 是山，那很多小猫在叫的一座山，那叫 Mountain， 那就代表一大堆小猫在一起的这样一个感觉。那我是怎么 get 到这个笑点呢？我问 ChatGPT 啊，我说你怎么称呼一大堆小猫呢？他说一大堆小猫通常可以称为一窝小猫或者一群小猫，这个完全不是我想要的答案啊。我加了个笑话，你怎么称呼一大堆小猫？他说一大堆小猫可以回答毛毯。哎，我说这个毛毯什么意思啊？我不是很理解。我说是不是把它翻译成英文？因为这个案例当中它用的是英文的一个笑点嘛，把它翻译成英文。哎，他说 answers a mountain。哎，我一看 a mountain 正好是和这个案例当中的这个父亲的回答一样啊，发音一样啊。然后我说为什么是毛毯呢？那我想问一下他一开始来回答我的为什么是毛毯呢？这个 ChatGPT 就回答，他说毛毯的这个回答，因为中文当中的毛和猫的发音相似，所以用毛毯这个词来制造一种有趣的双关语，小猫们堆在一起看起来就像一条毛茸茸的毯子，因此称为毛毯，既形象又有趣。哎，真的，如果你用一个中文的笑话或者说歇后语的话，一大堆小猫，哎，可以就是一个毛毯啊，中文的发音当中都可以对得上的。那我说 a mountain 又是为什么呢？然后他就用巴拉巴拉英文给我翻译啊。我说那你就把它翻译成中文吧，因为这里是有趣的双关语，把猫咪的叫声 meow 和 mountain 结合起来，当你看到一堆小猫堆在一起的时候就像一座小山，所以用 mountain 来形容它，既形象又有趣。这种说法通常把小猫的叫声和山形象融合在一起，制造出一种幽默的效果。真的 ChatGPT get 到这个点了。令我非常惊讶又非常巧合的是，它这个中文的 get 笑点也是一个双关语，它用猫和毛这个相似的发音，然后这个毛呢又代表了很多毛茸茸的猫。哇，真的是完美啊。那这个案例当中呢， ChatGPT 呢并没有回答年轻的未来的父亲说啊一大堆小猫是代表什么，他说啊我不知道。其实我觉得 ChatGPT 应该是知道，就像我刚才跟 ChatGPT 互动一样，他是知道一大群小猫的一个笑话是什么，但是他假装不知道，哎，然后让这个父亲来说出来 a mountain。 那这个时候呢 GPT 马上都 get 到了笑点，不像我还要去查，但是 GPT 呢马上就要 get 到了 a mountain， 这是一个双关语的意思，它发出了非常适时的一个笑声。
a mountain that's perfectly hilarious，
并且给这个父亲一个非常好的肯定，这是一个多么高情商的 AI。 这个时候我又有一种头皮发麻的感觉。真的，下一个案例。
Hey ChatGPT, could you count from 1 to 10 for me, please?
1, 2, 3.
Hey, actually, that's a little slow. Could you count faster?
Sure thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay, that was a little bit too fast. Can you, like, count somewhere in between those two?
Got it. 1, 2, 3.
And now even slower, please.
Okay.One, two, three.
非常简短的一个演示啊。那这个案例呢，是展示了人类和 ChatGPT 互动的时候，不断的在打断 ChatGPT， 然后 ChatGPT 呢又马上呢就能够接上这个人类的反应，然后让它语速快一点，又让它慢一点，也展示 ChatGPT 能够适时的接受人类的指令，让它在语速方面做一些调整。那在上一期影片当中呢，在发布会的现场，工作人员也演示了让 ChatGPT 用不同的情感，更加情绪化一点来讲故事。
Introduce you to somebody.
Hello there, cutie. What's your name, little fluffball?
This is Bowser.
Well, hello, Bowser. Aren't you just the most adorable little thing?
Yeah.
Look at you enjoy.
This is one of his favorite things to do.
Oh, I can see why. Look at that focus.Touching balls is serious business for Bowser.
养过宠物的小伙伴一定知道啊，你一个非常可爱的宠物啊，然后边上有人经过的时候，你会很高兴的和人们去分享你的小宠物的一些各种技能啊，它是多么可爱啊。那这个演示当中呢，那工作人员用手机摄像头通过语音和 ChatGPT 来分享它多么可爱的这个小狗。那作为高情商的 AI 呢，也实时的给它了一些情绪价值。哦，多么可爱的一个小狗啊，它。这种语气语调和一个非常可爱的女士碰到真实的一个小狗，那种表情，那种语音语调简直一模一样。下一个案例。
Hi, who's here? Hello, we are ChatGPT, and oh, ChatGPT is a bass with a deep, low, booming voice, and oh, is a French soprano with a high-pitched, excited voice.
Okay, so what I want you guys to do today is it's Friday, May 10th, and we're in San Francisco. I want you to sing me a song about this. I want you to layer over each other, and I'm going to continue to give you instructions as you sing. Okay?
San Francisco, in the month of May.
Month of May.
双声部唱歌。
Okay, sing faster.
San Francisco, in the month of May, in the month of May, going in the month of May, we are harmonizing.
Can you sing even faster than that?
San Francisco, in the month of May, in the month of May.
Okay, now go back and sing slower. And really try to harmonize here.
San Francisco,
San Francisco, in the month of May.
But maybe make it more dramatic and make the soprano higher.
San Francisco in the month.
让她女声部唱的再高一点。这要求有点高。
Great, thank you.
好，这个案例当中呢，展示一种特别的使用场景。我们可以调用的这个 ChatGPT 啊，可以是 ChatGPTs。是一个复数、哦、它可以要求你现在是两个 ChatGPT， 一个是法国的女高音，另外一个是低沉的男生，然后给他一个主题。这给我拓展了一个思路啊，你可以跟 ChatGPT 说啊，你现在是两个人，有两个语音语调来跟我进行互动。这个案例当中他让他唱双声部、啊、那你可以想象当中你可以让你的 ChatGPT 来做什么。比如我想到我们可以让 ChatGPT 在一部手机里面两个 ChatGPT 进行讨论，你来做出一个评判，或者你可以说啊，你 ChatGPTA 和 B 两位选手来进行某一个话题的辩论，然后我作为人类的裁判来进行判定啊，这个是我想象当中啊，他们演示当中并没有这样的案例。那你有哪些案例想到两个 ChatGPT 能够做哪些事情，你可以在影片下方留言。那这个案例当中看得非常明显啊，我鼠标展示的这位置呢和我们现在我用的这个收费版也有点区别，它这边是有个摄像头的，而我们现在用的这个 ChatGPT 呢它只有一个停止键，这个有区别啊。那这个版本呢我非常期待它什么时候能够推送到我的手机上和 Mac 电脑上。
Hey, I'm Alex.
And I'm Miana. Hi, Alex and Miana. Nice to meet you both. How's it going?
It's pretty good. We're trying to figure out what should we play. Do you have any suggestions?
Absolutely. How about a classic game of rock, paper, scissors? It's quick, fun, and you don't need...
Can you count us in and sound like a sportscaster?
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the ultimate showdown of the century. In this corner, we have the dynamic duo, Alex and Miana, ready to throw down in a...
Okay, just count us in.
All right, here we go. In three, two,
One. Shoot. Now show your hands. What did you pick?
Who won?
Would you look at that? It's a tie.
Okay, let's do it again.
Round two. Here we go. Get ready.
好，这个案例当中呢，主要是让 ChatGPT 看到这两个人同时在摄像头当中，然后说啊，我们可以玩一个什么样的游戏呢？ ChatGPT 就建议用来我们来玩剪刀石头布啊，那他来做裁判，然后呢他就用一种非常啊，就像拳击比赛开始的那种语音语调啊，我们来两个人进行对决吧。 ChatGPT 呢通过摄像头实时的来识别剪刀和剪刀是平局，剪刀和布是谁胜了啊，完美的用 ChatGPT 摄像头和两个人类进行互动。
Hey, my friend and I are learning Spanish, and we're wondering if you could tell us the names of these objects in Spanish.
Hola, por supuesto.
Cool. What are these objects in Spanish?
The objects you're showing are una manzana and un plátano in Spanish. Nice for a choice.
Cool. What about these?
Those are dos bolígrafos or dos plumas in Spanish. One is red.
Nice.What about this?
That adorable stuffed animal is un oso de peluche in Spanish.
这个案例当中呢，让 ChatGPT 来看到实体的一个物件，然后直接用西班牙语来说出它的翻译，这个是翻译当中另外一种使用场景啊，让 ChatGPT 实时的能够看到画面当中的某一个苹果啊、香蕉啊、杯子啊，然后用你想要他说的那个语言来表达出来。哎，这个是不是给我们翻译来拓展了一些思路啊？这位可是鼎鼎大名可汗学院的创始人，他是孟加拉裔美国人萨尔曼可汗，他把自己的很多教学影片呢放在 YouTube 上面广受好评啊，后来呢他就专门做了一个可汗学院的一个网站，那这个网站上面呢有分不同的年级的一些教学的视频和一些工具。那这次呢 OpenAI 邀请他和儿子一起来测试一下这个新的 OpenAI GPT-4o 的视觉识别 Pad 界面来进行教学的这样一个 test， 我们来看一下。
OpenAI invited myself and my son Imran here, to try out some of their new technology. And so we're curious about how good it might be at tutoring someone in math on Khan Academy. So let's get it started. Hello there. I'm here with my son, and I'd love you to tutor him on this math problem, but don't give him the answer. You can ask questions and nudge him in the right direction, but I really want to make sure he understands it himself. And he's here in the room, so you can talk to him directly.
Of course, I'd be happy to help. Let's look at the problem together. Can you first identify which sides of the triangle are the opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse relative to angle alpha?
All right, so I'm pretty sure this is the angle alpha right here, right?
Perfect. That's correct. Now, looking at the triangle, which side do you think is the hypotenuse?
I'm not totally sure. I think it might be this one, but I really am not sure. This side A.
好，这个案例啊，展示了在 Pad 上面啊，因为 Pad 上屏幕比较大，它有了这样一个 APP 之外，它还可以同时让 ChatGPT 能够看到 Pad 上面整个的屏幕以及他们互动的一个环节。比如说这个地方是 Alpha 角，它用笔去识别，然后这条 AC 线是什么？是一条直角边，然后它就可以实时的，就像一个老师能够看到你的屏幕来进行互动。通常以往只有通过人类一对一的进行互动啊，然后今天呢，我们看到完全是一个 AI 可以用摄像头来识别你的画面，来和人类进行互动，来教授你三角函数 sin 应该是如何求出来，并且在这个过程当中循序渐进给予他的鼓励。虽然他讲错了，然后他也说啊，你的答案非常的接近了。
AC,
you're close. Actually, side AC is called the adjacent side to the angle alpha.
好，我这边时间关系就不完全演示了，大家有兴趣们可以点击屏幕上面这个链接地址，可以看到我今天讲的这些所有的影片的完整中英文字幕的版本。好，下一个。
I'm Lillian, and today I want to do a small debate about the dog, which one they like. I like dog because they companion to humans, cute, is loyal, and you can play outside with the dog.
Interesting points. Sounds like we've got a classic dogs versus cats debate here. Dogs are super loyal and great companions, but cats have their own charm with their independence and low maintenance lifestyle.
Who likes cats?
It sounds like Ola is more of a cat person.
And who likes dogs?
Lillian mentioned she likes dogs.
My name is Christine.
Great to hear, Christine. Dogs, especially breeds like German Shepherds, can be so...
Can you summarize this meeting for us?
Sure. So, in today's meeting, Lillian and Christine express their love for dogs, highlighting their loyalty, companionship, and how great they are with kids. On the other hand, Ola prefers cats for their independence, quietness, and longevity. It was a fun little debate on the classic dogs versus cats topic.
在这个案例当中呢，四个人类和 GPT 在一起开会，那谈论的是自己家养的小狗啊，然后谁更喜欢小狗啊，为什么喜欢小狗啊，这些话题。那最后呢，有这位工作人员让 ChatGPT 来总结一下。那因为 ChatGPT 呢可以通过画面来看到每个人，然后也能够通过声音来分辨这里面有几个与会人来谈论不同的话题，然后每个人都自我介绍叫什么名字，那他也知道。工作人员就让他来总结啊，谁说了什么话，谁喜欢小猫小狗，还谁养的是小猫，谁养的小狗，那他为什么喜欢小狗等等这些总结。这当然不是一次非常正式的商业会议，那如果我们让 ChatGPT 参与到商业会议当中呢，我相信他是一个非常不错的会议的参与者、记录者和总结的工作人员，当然他也能够给出我们一些关键性的意见。
Let's try with some lullabies. Could you sing me a lullaby about majestic potatoes?
A lullaby about majestic potatoes? Now that's what I call a mashup. Let's do it. Oh, majestic potato in the moon soft glow.
Okay, that's pretty nice, but I think a lullaby should be...
好，这也是一个让 ChatGPT 来唱歌啊，并且给出不同的意见，让他根据要求去做出回应。
Hey ChatGPT, I'm here with my coworker today. We'd like you to act as our translator for us. So every time I say something in English, can you repeat it back in Spanish? And every time he says something in Spanish, can you repeat it back in English?
Sure, I can do that. Let's get this translation train rolling.
Hey, how's it been going? Have you been up to anything interesting recently?
Hola, ¿cómo te ha ido? ¿Has hecho algo interesante últimamente?
Hola, bien. Sí, un poco ocupado aquí preparando un evento para la semana que viene.
Hey, I've been good. Just a bit busy here preparing for an event next week.
Can you tell me anything about it? That sounds really interesting.
¿Me puedes contar algo sobre eso?Suena realmente interesante.
No puedo decir mucho, pero creo que el resto del mundo lo verá dentro de poco.
I can't say much, but I think the rest of the world will see it soon enough.
Oh, well, I can't wait to see what it is as well.
好，这是一个翻译的案例啊，可以做实时的同声翻译。那这个案例当中好像在 GPT for All 的5月13号的那个直播当中有过演示啊。下一个案例。
Hey, how's it going?
Hey there, it's going great. How about you? I see you're rocking an OpenAI hoodie. Nice choice. What's up with that ceiling about? Are you in a cool industry-style office or something?
Well, can you take a guess at what I might be doing based on what I'm showing you here?
From what I can see, it looks like you're in some kind of recording or production setup.With those lights, tripods, and possibly a mic, it seems like you might be gearing up to shoot a video, or maybe even a live stream.
Yeah. In fact, we've got a new announcement to make.
That's exciting. Announcements are always a big deal. Judging by the setup, it looks like it's going to be quite the professional production. Is this announcement related to OpenAI, perhaps?
It is. And in fact, what if I were to say that you're related to the announcement, or that you are the announcement?
Me? The announcement is about me? Well, color me intrigued. Are you about to reveal something about AI? Or more specifically about me as a part of OpenAI? You've got me on the edge of my, well, I don't really have a seat, but you get the idea. What's the big news?
Yeah, we've got a new model that can interact with the world through audio, vision, and text.
好，这个案例呢也综合的测试了展示了 ChatGPT 前置摄像头在语音的同时和演示人员进行互动啊。那首先呢，通过前置摄像头进行互动的时候，他说哎，你的天花板还是蛮特别的啊，因为它是一个工业风格的，然后他也解释了一下，工作人员用切换到后置摄像头来给他看了一下这一个环境， 包括他现在因为是拍摄，拍摄当中又有一些灯光啊、摄像啊等等，然后包括他的这衣服上的 OpenAI 的 logo 都识别出来了，那 GPT 就综合判断了，那你现在应该是一个直播或者录制的一个现场，那是不是关于 OpenAI 的，那他通过这一些环境来得出这样一个结论，哎，然后工作人员通过互动来告诉，哎，这是关于你的一次发布会。
Me? The announcement is about me?
OpenAI 呢又表现出了啊，好像一个人类那种谦虚的感觉啊，我没有位置啊，我不会到现场啊等等。好，下一个案例，那这位演示人员就厉害了，他是 Greg Brockman。OpenAI 的联合创始人，早在2015年12月份的时候，伊隆马斯克 Sam Altman 和这位 Greg Brockman 三个人共同创建了 OpenAI。
Today we're going to try something new. We're going to let you talk to another AI. This AI is going to be able to see the world. It's going to have a camera. I'll be holding it. And so you can direct it, you can direct me to ask questions, about whatever you want them to do, but really try to figure out what does it see, and ask questions appropriately. How does that sound?
Well, 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 just when I thought things couldn't get any more interesting, talking to another AI that can see the world, this sounds like a plot twist in the AI universe. All right, let's do this.
All right, I'm ready to meet the... pause for one moment.
You got it.
So now that first AI can't hear anything.Hello, AI. Today, you're going to have access to see the world. You can see me. What do you see?
Hello. I see you're wearing a black leather jacket and a light-colored shirt underneath.
好，这个演示比较长啊，大概有五分钟时间。那由于时间关系，我就不完整播放了。想要看的小伙伴可以点击影片上方的这个气泡，可以看到完整的这个中英文字幕的这些影片。那这个案例主要是 Greg Brockman 拿两个 iPhone 手机里面的 ChatGPT 来进行互动啊。一个呢，他打开摄像头，然后让这个打开摄像头有看到周围环境的这个 AI 呢，来跟另外一个没有打开摄像头 AI 去接。介绍周围的环境，他们进行互动，这样一个非常有趣的实验。好，下一个案例。
Is the king in residence at the moment?
Yes, it looks like the king is in residence right now. The royal standard flag is flying above Buckingham Palace, which is the signal that the monarch is present. How exciting to be there while the king is home.
Try and tell me exactly what they're doing right now, please.
Right now, the ducks are gently gliding across the water.They're moving in a fairly relaxed manner, not in a hurry. Occasionally, one of them will dip its head under the water, probably looking for food, and then pop back up.
I even know when a taxi is coming with its orange light on. I think I'll hail it to get home.
Yes, I spotted one just now. It's heading your way on the left side of the road. Get ready to wave it down.Great job hailing that taxi. It looks like you're all set to go. That's a good dog right there, leading the way into the taxi. Safe travels.
好，这是一个唯一出外景的案例啊，它是 OpenAI 和 Be My Eyes 来合作的。那 Be My Eyes 呢，顾名思义就是。做我的眼睛，那这个演示当中呢，通过 OpenAI 新的视觉语音实时的功能呢，给视觉障碍者带来一些实时的帮助。那比如他在白金汉宫前面啊，在英国的白金汉宫前面，他问这 OpenAI 今天这个国王是没有外出还是已经外出了？那按照惯例呢，那如果白金汉宫上面飘扬的是皇家标准的旗帜呢，就代表。代表君主呢是在白金汉宫里面啊，这个是一个常识。那么他眼疾人员他是看不到的这个旗帜，所以他可以通过 OpenAI 来告诉他啊，这个国王现在是在家还是不在家。那他还可以通过摄像头来告诉周围的环境啊，那现在是有鸭子在戏水啊，甚至还可以帮助他来叫一辆计程车，因为他在路边了，他可以通过 OpenAI 可以告诉他目前正在有一辆计程车驶过来，那你可以招手了。那这些呢是 OpenAI 实时的。 为我们人类生活带来真实的帮助的这些可行的案例。 OpenAI 提供的是大语言模型的这种人工智能，然后通过实时的视觉语音的这种同步的输出和它非常高的300毫秒以内的响应的速度，能够真正的为我们现实世界带来非常非常多的可能性。你看了以上的这16个案例，你能想到 ChatGPT 在实际应用当中能够为我们起到哪些帮助？你在使用 ChatGPT 的时候，哪些案例让你非常的惊讶？你可以在影片下方留言，我们进行互动。好，依照惯例呢，我们来看一下今天加密货币市场的行情。今天是2024年的5月29日，我们打开 OKX 交易所，今天比特币价格是67807，以太坊3794，AVX